There's so much to learn, so much to explore. From the surface of the water to the ocean floor, it's Porky's Ocean Patrol. Yes, Porky's Ocean Patrol.
Ahoy, my friends. Welcome to Porky's Ocean Patrol, a show with me, Porky, and my friends Georgie, Kaurna, and you, my ocean patrollers. Together, we'll discover all about our great southern reef, the wonderful sea creatures that call it home, and how we can all keep our oceans happy and healthy. The ocean, known as sea country, is an important part of Aboriginal culture, and we all play an important role caring for the sea. My friend Kaurna can help us learn more about Aboriginal culture. Nina Mani, Chase.
Nina Mani, Porky and Kaurna, how did you go fishing a long time ago?
You've got me on the edge of my fishy seat with that one.
Well, let me tell you, fishing a long time ago was a real adventure. People had to get creative and use what they had. There were lots of fishing options. Using spears, using your bare hands, and making fishing hooks out of animal bones. And I'd like to share one of those options with you. My ancestors used a special type of reed called the knobby clubrush reed. Sometimes the bulrush reed. These reeds were like nature's fishing gear.
Reeds, those tall, slender plants you might see near the water. Nature's goodies.
What we did was take those reeds and turn them into strong and flexible strings for fishing line. We'd weave and twist those reeds until they formed sturdy strings. And you know what's cool? We'd also use these for bindings on shelters and also as fasteners for our clothing.
Wow, thank you, Kaurna. I'm going to try this at home. Incoming call from a budding marine explorer. Time to splash into action. Hey, Georgie. Ahoy there.
Ahoy, Porky. Why are plastic bags bad for the environment?
Hey, Charlotte. That's a fantastic question.
Sure is, Porky. Plastic bags are a real underwater no-no. You see, even though they seem harmless, they can cause serious trouble tangling up animals and looking like food. They take a long time to break up too, like 10 to 20 years. And when they do break up, they don't disappear. They turn into teeny tiny pieces.
And that's where the problem starts, kiddos. Those tiny pieces can be super harmful to ocean life.
Exactly. Marine creatures like seabirds, whales, fish and turtles sometimes confuse these plastic bits for tasty snacks. But that's a big mistake. Their tummies can fill up with plastic and can even starve because of it.
Now, some plastic bags are labelled as green and degradable, or naturally degradable. Sounds nice, right? But here's the twist. You need to look at the label closely, as a lot of these bags break down into even smaller pieces. But they're still made from regular plastic, so they're not really green at all.
And the term biodegradable can be tricky too. In some places, like the USA, products are only allowed to be called biodegradable if they completely break down in nature within 5 years. But here in Australia, some regular plastic bags are labelled biodegradable, which can be misleading.
So, what can our awesome ocean patrollers do? Well, reusing bags is a fantastic start. And always check the label when you're shopping. Stay away from those degradable bags. And remember, compostable bags made from natural plant starch are a much better choice. They break down in the compost without harming the environment.
That's spot on, Porky.
Ooh.
Ahoy, Porky. Where in South Australia can I go and visit the little penguins in the wild?
Way to make a splash with your question, Lola. Our adorable friends, the little penguins, love to hang out in all of southern Australian and New Zealand waters. These tiny feathered pop stars are seabirds that don't fly. Normally they live 6.5 years, but reported to live as long as 25 years. There are actually 17 species of penguins in the world. The little penguin is the smallest. One of the coolest spots to catch these pint-sized celebrities in action is on Granite Island, off the coast of Victor Harbour. But here's the catch. Their numbers on the island have taken a bit of a dip lately. There are only about 20 of them left. You see, these little penguins have faced some challenges, like less fishy snacks due to climate change and other marine predators trying to make them their dinner. But fear not, we can all be heroes for our penguin pals. 1. Always toss your rubbish in the bin. 2. Keep your pets away from their hangout spots. 3. If you ever spot anyone causing trouble for these little champs, don't be shy, report it pronto. And during their busy breeding season from May to February, let's be extra considerate. Keep it down around their nesting areas. It's like their quiet time. No flash photography, please. Bright lights can give them quite the fright. If you're out on a boat, steer clear. So go ahead and visit these adorable penguins. But always remember to be a responsible ocean patroller. Let's keep their homes safe and sound. How long does it take for a plastic bag to break up? 1. 10 to 20 years. 2. 200 years. 3. 5 years. Answer is 10 to 20 years. What reed can be made into fishing line? 1. Bulrush and knobby club reed. 2. Cowslow and ruby club reed. 3. Any weeds will do. Answer, bulrush and knobby club reed. Guess what time it is, Ocean Patrollers? It's Porky's activity time. Head over to my website for this week's activity to download. You can become a Porky's Ocean Patroller too and protect our wonderful sea creatures and their homes by taking your very own Porky's Ocean Pledge. Find the special POP Pledge certificate with the link I've put in the description. Thanks for watching. It's been swell. See you next time.
Porky's Ocean Patrol.